electrochemical theory of corrosion. Wet corrosion usually occurs in conducting liquid medium. This corrosion can be explained with the help of electrochemical theory. Before understanding this theory, let us understand few important points. What is electrochemical cell and what are its components? Electrochemical cell is a device which generates electricity. The components are anode, cathode, and an electrolyte. Now let us understand electrochemical theory. Whenever a base metal, let us assume iron, is exposed to different oxygen concentration, there will be a formation of anodic area and cathodic area. Whenever a dust particle settles on the metal surface, area below the dust particle having less oxygen, which acts as anode, whereas rest of the area where dust is not covered having more oxygen concentration acts as anode. Hence, there will be a formation of anodic and cathodic areas that are not widely separated. A presence of an electrolyte in the medium like moisture in contact with these areas results a tiny large number of chemical cells, that is called as tiny electrochemical cells or galvanic cells. Whenever there is a chance for such tiny cells to form, chemical reactions leads to corrosion. The metal acts as electronic conductor, and the solution, that is water, on it, which completes the circuit by conducting ions. Now let us see the reactions which are taking place. At anode, metal undergoes oxidation, that is corrosion, with the release of electrons. The metal ions get into the environment and the electrons migrate to the cathodic areas where they are absorbed, that is which undergo reduction. If the electrons are not absorbed at the cathodic area, corrosion will not be proceeded. Let us see the cathodic reactions. The metal at the cathodic area will not take up the electrons. It does not have the tendency. Therefore, if at all electrons are consumed, it must be some species in the environment. Species, it may be an oxygen or it may be neutral or any other medium. The environment to which the metal is exposed can be acidic or alkaline or neutral, and it may or may not contain oxygen. Depend upon the type of environment, electrons are absorbed by the different mechanisms. Now let us understand hydrogen evolution mechanism at the cathode. Hydrogen gas is released when electrons are absorbed in presence of acidic medium. Similar observations were made when electrons are absorbed in neutral or alkaline medium. In both the cases, hydrogen gas is evolved, hence it is called as hydrogen evolution mechanism at the cathode. Let us see the reactions at cathode in presence of oxygen. Water is produced when in presence of acidic medium electrons are absorbed. In case of neutral or alkaline medium, electrons are absorbed and get converted to the hydroxide ion. Here some of the points to be noted. Oxidation and reductions are two simultaneous processes. If there is no environment or suitable environment for the reduction to occur or oxidation to occur, corrosion will not take place. That is why a metal is kept in vacuum, does not undergo corrosion. Metal will not undergo corrosion at cathodic area as it is not involved in any cathodic reaction. As most of our environments are neutral or alkaline, formation of hydroxide ions are under these conditions is the most common reactions. Now let us see some of the final reactions. Iron ions forms at the anode will combine with the hydroxide ion to convert into ferrous hydroxide, which is the primary corrosion product, which is unstable. Immediately in presence of oxygen and water, it get converted to final corrosion product, that is iron oxide or Fe2O3 into 3C2. This is the final corrosion product when an iron metal is exposed to corrosive environment. This is a theory related to when a single metal is exposed to different oxygen concentrations. You can explain the same theory when a two different metals is exposed to corrosive environment, where one metal acts as anode, depend upon the position in the electrochemical series, and other metal acts as cathodes. The metal which is highly reactive, which acts as anode, and the metal which is less reactive acts as cathode. Moisture comes in contact with these areas, results in electrochemical cells, and once again corrosion also occurs. Corrosion occurs only at the anodes. Cathodic part does not undergo any corrosion also. These are the summary of the electrochemical theory reactions. At anode, metal undergoes oxidation. At cathode, these electrons are absorbed, depend upon the medium. It may be acidic or neutral or alkaline medium. In general, there are three possible ways in which reduction also takes place. They are the cathodic reactions and the final reactions, where actually first primary corrosion product is formed, which is unstable. Immediately, in presence of oxygen, in presence of water, it get converted to hydrated ferric oxide. That is our final corrosion product. Examination corner. The first question related to dry corrosion definition. This type of corrosion occurs in absence of moisture. Example, when a piece of iron at normal temperature is exposed to dry oxygen, or a metal is heated in a foundry at around 800 degrees centigrade, it absorbs moisture. Without moisture, it undergo oxidative corrosion. Second question, differentiate between dry and wet corrosion. With the help of examples, we can differentiate. The question number 3 and 4, which are related to wet corrosion mechanism, that is electrochemical theory of corrosion. We have to explain this with the help of a set of reactions along with the neat label diagram.